Hi, I'm Bruce Melnick, and I'm behind the scenes at BBC's Newsround. I wanted to be an astronaut from the age of 11 when Alan Shepard, the first American astronaut, flew in space. Now, I'm not going to lie to you, it's not easy to become an astronaut. A matter of fact, it took me 10 years of applying after I had a lot of experience of being a Coast Guard helicopter pilot. 10 years of applying, 6 applications, and I finally got selected in 1987 to become an astronaut. And if space travel is something you have a passion for, here are my 5 tips to becoming an astronaut. So tip number 1, you have to live and breathe space. You've got to really have a passion for it. You've got to read about it. You've got to study it. You can come to the Kennedy Space Center Visitor Complex, where you can meet a live astronaut that's flown into space before and experience what it's like. You might even be able to see a launch while you're there and take off. In any case, it's going to take many years of work and a lot of education before you're going to be qualified to be accepted to be an astronaut. And having that underlying passion will help you keep focused. My second tip is study real hard. Get the best education you can and really focus on the science, technology, and engineering and math subjects. Those are the subjects that came easy to me, and hopefully they'll come easy to you, but those are the important subjects to study if you want to be an astronaut. My third tip is to be persistent. You've got to really want it. As I mentioned even earlier, that it took me 6 tries and 10 years before I got accepted into the astronaut corps. If you do get pushed back, use those years to gain experience and to study even harder and learn more so that you can be a better astronaut when you finally get accepted. Tip number 4 is that you have to be fighting fit to fly into space. It's a very demanding job. You have to stay focused. The days are long when you're working in space. And also, you have to be fit to fight those G's, the G-forces that you feel when you're going up in a rocket. And also, after you've spent a long time in space in zero gravity, your body wants to try to relax because you don't have to be as strong up there. So you have to exercise and maintain your fitness while you're up there so that when you come back down to Earth and you feel the force of gravity again, that you're going to be healthy when you come back. Tip number 5 is you need to be a good communicator. Just think of the many subjects and topics that you're going to have to be knowledgeable in when you're up there in space and you're working those experiments and sending satellites off and getting data and doing all that research when you're up there. You're going to have to communicate that information back to people on the ground, because very few people get to fly in space, and you're going to need to tell that information to all different kinds of people. Also, you might have to learn Russian if you're going to go up on the International Space Station, because we also have Russian colleagues up there. So even in space station, you need to know 2 languages. So keep thinking about that. Those are my top 5 tips to being an astronaut. Even with all these 5 tips, and even if you do all these things, becoming an astronaut is really selective. The year that I finally got accepted, there was about 5,000 people that wanted to be astronauts. They only interviewed 120 of us and selected 15. So you can see that I feel like I'm a very lucky person that I got to fly in space. So my advice to you is, even though you want to be an astronaut, make sure that as you go through school and you finally get into an occupation and do a job, make sure you're doing a job that you really enjoy doing, in just the outside chance you don't get selected as an astronaut. I hope you follow your passion and are inspired to be that next generation of our future astronauts. Good luck with that.